Hello everyone. Today, I'm going to use Adobe Illustrator to make cherry blossom design for my flap closures shoulder bag. And this design is going to be printed out on the fabric. It's going to be the flap of my bag. First, create an artboard. Size is 12 inches by 7 inches. And I'm going to create an art brush to draw the design. Use ellipse tool to draw an ellipse shape, and the fill is black, the stroke is none. And create an art brush, choose tint and stretch to fit. And I'm going to use this brush to lay out the cherry blossom branches. And I need to change the fidelity of the brush. Double click the brush tool and change it to smooth. This is going to be the basic layout. And I'm going to try different stroke weight. Now 2 points looks pretty big. And I'm going to adjust branches to curl each one a little bit. Make them look more natural. This is the basic layout. Now I need to change the brush. Make a new brush. This new brush is going to be bigger on both ends and smaller in the middle. So I'm going to use the first brush I'm going to add two anchor points on each end of this small brush. And adjust the end anchor points, make the ends a little bigger than the center. After I finish, I'll add it to my brush collection and drag it to my brushes and select art brush and set the other reference numbers. Now I'm going to replace the brush strokes with this new brush. And I'm going to change the color to a light brown. And I'm going to make a third brush, which is going to be placed on the end branches. So the tip, one end, I don't need to change it. The other end, instead of bigger than the center, I will make it smaller, kind of pointed tip. After finish this, just drag it into my brushes. Choose art brush, it stretch to fit, and the color is tint. And I'm gonna replace the end branches with this new pointed end brush. And now I'm gonna draw the flower petals. I'm using the first block brush I made to draw a random circle and join the start and end points, and then delete the extra anchor points and make the join convert to round point. And change the stroke to 9, fill to black. And then I'm going to adjust the petal shape. I'm using direct selection tool to adjust each anchor points. I'm going to use this teal blue color as my petal, the main color of my petal, flower petals. And then I'm gonna add some shades to the petal. I'm using this Coriander curve tool. to draw the highlight section of the petal. And after the highlight, below the highlight should be a shade, darker part of the petal. Also, I'm using the same tool, Coventure tool, to draw these shades. And then after finished this drawing, I'm going to group all layers together and then make it a brush by drag it into my brushes and make it art brush. And now I'm going to change the colors to grayscale. That way you can choose any color when you use this brush. And then I'm going to try it out. It looks like I need to change the shades a little bit because the highlight section is too light, especially the center, so I'm going to change that. And also the flower petals, I need to change the shape, make it more pointed toward the center. Change the shades to more closer color grades. And I need to change the highlight a little. Instead of evenly wavy, I'm going to change it to arch shape to make it look more realistic. By doing so, I use anchor point delete tool, delete some extra points, and then move some points toward upper section of the petal. And I'm going to use the same manner to change, to modify these shades. Now let me try out. Looks pretty good. Then I'm going to make this my new brush. Now let me try it out. It looks good. So this is going to be my flower cherry blossom, and I'm going to make copies and place these flowers to the entire cherry tree branches. And I also need to draw a center of the cherry flowers. So use the same brush, randomly draw a circle and choose a color. Fill color and stroke color is none. I'm choosing a very pale pink color and place it in the center of the flower and move it to the back. And then group all these. The first flower is made. I'm gonna make a copies and by press down option key and place it all over the branches. And I'm going to make a different flower shape, which is consists of three petals in the center. To do so, just choose the art brush we just made and draw it. And place the center behind these three petals. The next thing I need to do is to make copies of these half flowers, full flower, and half flowers, and arrange them in the design. just make copies and move them around until you're satisfied with your design. You can also add a background. In this image, I add a very light gray background. You don't have to, but in order to be closer to the colors of my fabric for the body of the bag, I add this background with a light gray feel. This is the final design, and I'm gonna print it out onto my pre-treated 100% cotton fabric. It's going to be the flap of my new bag, which I'm going to make a tutorial on how to make that bag. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and like so you will not miss my new uploads. See you next time.